दिस एंजल टैक्स इज लेवीड ऑन द एंजल इन्वेस्टमेंट. दिस इज लेवीड ऑन द एंजल इन्वेस्टमेंट. एंड व्हाई दिस इज लेवीड? सो जस्ट लिसन टू दिस एग्जाम्पल केयरफुल्ली. सपोज दिस इज अ स्टार्टअप कंपनी and this company has the shares of rupees 100 each. Which will be issued to anyone who want to invest. And the money will be invested into the startup company. Right? This is an angel investor. For example, Mr. X. Now, the value of this equity share is 100 rupees. Startup company says that we are in a very futuristic business. Suppose, for example, startup company says that we have innovated the COVID-19 vaccine and our future market value is going to be wonderful. The value of this share is going to be 1 lakh rupees per share. Right? And hello. And this Mr. X, it invests in the startup company at 1 lakh rupees per equity share. So angel investor pays 1 lakh rupees per equity share to the startup company. Hai na? Now, in this transaction, there are some issues. What are the issues? This 1 lakh rupees per share has been claimed by the startup company. Startup company ne claim kiya ki मेरे शेयर की वैल्यू 1 लाख रुपए है. लेकिन क्या ये 1 लाख रुपए हो गया उसके कहने से? डज इट बिक लाइक डज 1 लाख रुपीज वर्थ ऑफ लाइक इज इट रियली द 1 लाख रुपीज वर्थ शेयर? इट इज नॉट ऑलवेज पॉसिबल दैट दिस एस्टिमेट 1 लाख रुपीज इज करेक्ट. सो देर इज ऑलवेज ए फेयर मार्केट वैल्यू. फेयर मार्केट वैल्यू इज valuation is done by professional agencies based upon various factors, that what is the business of the company, what is the competition. So for example, this company says that we have innovated the COVID-19 vaccine, so our sale is going to be very very big, right? But this fair market valuation says that although you have innovated a good vaccine, but There will be government regulations upon your business, because you cannot sell the vaccine at a very huge cost. This is an essential item. So government will put some restriction. And not only this, but also there will be other competitors who will be developing the vaccine in the near future. So your business will not have so much of value in the future. So please, like the fair market value of your business is just 20,000 rupees per equity share. Hai na? Aapke jo equity share ki value hai, that is not 1 lakh rupees, rather just 20,000 rupees. But this angel investor has paid 1 lakh rupees. So the government says that this angel, there can be some malicious intention. There can be some intentional transaction whereby the angel investor already knew that the value of this share is only 20,000. The value of this share is only 20,000, but he invested because he had some black money. So angel investor invested 1 lakh rupees minus 20,000 per share. That is 80,000 per share of the black money. So this 80,000 is the black money और अनअकाउंटेड मनी. सो वी विल लेवी द टैक्स ऑन दिस 80,000 रुपीज मनी. टैक्स ऑन 80,000 रुपीज एंड दिस टैक्स विल बी एट द रेट ऑफ 30%. राइट. सो द लॉजिक इज दैट दिस एंजल इन्वेस्टर्स दे आर कन्वर्टिंग देयर ब्लैक मनी इंटू व्हाइट मनी बाय बाइंग द शेयर्स ऑफ एनी स्टार्टअप कंपनी एट अ वेरी हाई वैल्यू. इस किसी भी स्टार्टअप कंपनी के शेयर को वो बहुत हाई वैल्यू पर बाय कर लेते हैं और अपने जो ब्लैक मनी होता है उसको व्हाइट मनी में कन्वर्ट कर लेते हैं. बिकॉज वंस दे हैव परचेज द शेयर्स ऑफ स्टार्टअप कंपनी सो दे कैन ऑलवेज से दैट दिस इज अवर कॉस्ट एंड इन फ्यूचर वेन दे विल बी सेलिंग देयर शेयर्स दे कैन ऑलवेज एडजस्ट दिस 1 lakh रुपीज एज द कॉस्ट. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एंजल टैक्स. सो एनी डाउट टू एनी वन एज ऑफ नाउ? अभी तक किसी को डाउट है क्या? अल्टीमेटली व्हाट इज एंजल टैक्स? एंजल टैक्स इज एक बेसिकली द टैक्स ऑन the price paid by angel investor above fair market value. है ना? Fair market value के above जो पेमेंट एंजल इन्वेस्टर ने किए हैं उस पर जो टैक्स होता है उसको एंजल टैक्स बोलते हैं. बट हियर देर इज ए कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी. द कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी इज दैट हाउ दिस फेयर मार्केट वैल्यू विल बी कैलकुलेटेड. हु विल कैलकुलेट दिस फेयर मार्केट वैल्यू? व्हाट विल बी द क्राइटेरिया ऑफ दिस फेयर मार्केट वैल्यू? देर आर मेनी केसेस, जेन्युइन केसेस वेयर रियली द बिजनेस future is very very good and that is why the angel investor have invested a big amount. So the case is very genuine, but the tax department is creating unnecessary suspicion and tax department is sending the notices to the startup. So startup started facing a lot of problem from the government, from the income tax department. They started facing the problem that we are doing the genuine business, someone is investing into our company, and the tax department wants to collect the tax even before we have started our own business. So that started creating the problem because those angel investors, they stopped investing into the new startup. So everyone please mute your phone because I can hear some of you which is creating a distraction in the class. So basically it created the problem in the genuine cases and the startup community, they went to the Prime Minister, they met with the Finance Minister and they raised this issue. So finally in budget 2019, that is last year, some relaxation were given for the genuine cases, right? So this term was a lot of time in news in the last year, that is why this becomes important, right? So let us see from our study material about this angel tax, and then after that if you have any doubt you can ask me. So please read this yourself and after that we will discuss. So basically angel tax is applicable on the capital raised by unlisted companies. Unlisted company kya hota hai? Those companies which are not listed on the stock exchange. It means those companies who have not yet made any public issue, right? So they are going for the private placement. They are selling their shares to some individuals, right? They are not selling their shares to the public. So that is why this is applicable in case of unlisted company, not in case of listed company, right? From any individual against an issue of shares in excess of fair market value. The tax has been classified as income from other sources, right? So income from other sources is a category of income inside the Income Tax Act. Na? So Income Tax Act mein, there are various type of income. For example, salary income, business income, capital gain, which we discussed in the taxation chapter. Similarly, there is income from other source. So this kind of income, that is rupees 80,000, which I gave in my example, those 80,000 are basically classified as income from other source, and the tax is levied on that income. So this tax was introduced in 2012 as an anti-abuse provision, as the government sought to stop the practice of issuing the shares in unlisted companies at high premium. So basically, in some cases, actually the black money was being converted into the white money. So the unlisted companies, the new companies, they were issuing the shares to some individuals at a very high cost. So those individuals were able to convert their black money into the white money. So actually that happened. Then only government came up with this angel tax. But some genuine cases were also caught up in this provision, right? So simply put, angel tax is 30.9% tax levied on investment made by investor in the startup or companies. To clarify, the entire investment is not taxed, right? So in our example, we took the example of 1 lakh rupees. So entire 1 lakh rupees is not taxed. Only the amount that is considered above the fair value valuations of the startup is taxed. That is amount above 20,000, that is amount of 80,000 is taxed. Currently the angel tax is applicable to the individual investors, right? So this is applicable only in case of individual investor, right? Because the chances of black money are more in individual investor. If it is a proper fund, if it is a proper venture capital fund, which is a registered NBFC, then that fund must be maintaining some accounts, that fund must be complying some regulations. So the chances of any black money there are very, very less. So this angel tax is applicable only and only in case of individual investor. This is not applicable in case of venture capital fund, and this is also not applicable in case of non-resident, because we want to increase the foreign investment, we want to increase FDI and FII. So this provision is not applicable in case of foreign investment. While the clause did not apply to startup receiving fund from registered venture capital investor, hai na? And AIF 1 category, what is AIF 1 category? AIF 1 category is basically alternative investment fund category 1. So those alternative investment fund which are really contributing to the economy. So we will discuss about it. What is the meaning of alternative investment fund? We will discuss about it in this session only. Angel investors are not recognized as the venture capital fund. So we have already discussed the difference between the two, the difference between the angel investors and the venture capital funds. Okay. Now, budget 2019 announcement, which I told that this angel tax, now it has been relaxed. To resolve the so-called angel tax issue, startups and their investors who file requisite declaration and provide information in their return will not be subjected to any kind of scrutiny in respect of valuation of share premium. Hai na? So, I have told you that the major problem jo hai, the controversy is about this fair market value, that how to calculate this fair market value. The major controversy is about this. Hai na? So, if the startup and the investor, they are providing complete information and they are declaring clearly in their income tax return that okay, I received 1 lakh rupees and this one is received from Mr. X. And Mr. X is also telling that I brought this money from this area. So there is complete information. That means like this is a genuine case. So in case of genuine case, there will be no angel tax scrutiny. Matlab, income tax department will not ask you ki bhai paisa kahan se aaya, kahan pe leke ja rahe ho, hai na? The issue of establishing the identity of the investor and source of this fund will be resolved by putting in place a mechanism of e-verification, hai na? So basically income tax department will put up some e-verification mechanism through which the identity of the investor, ki Mr. X kon hai, इसकी सोर्स ऑफ फंड क्या है, क्या वो ब्लैक मनी है या व्हाइट मनी है, इज इट टैक्स पेड और इज इट नॉट टैक्स पेड. वी कैन एक्चुअली लाइक इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट विल एक्चुअली पुट ए ई वेरिफिकेशन मैकेनिज्म. द बेनिफिट वाज आल्सो एक्सटेंडेड टू कैटेगरी टू एआईएफ, है ना? तो पहले इट वाज ओनली फॉर कैटेगरी वन एआईएफ, नाउ इट हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड टू कैटेगरी वन एआईएफ आल्सो. देयरफॉर द वैल्यूएशन ऑफ शेयर्स इश्यूड टू दिस फंड्स शैल बी बियॉन्ड द scope of income tax scrutiny. So income tax department will not conduct any scrutiny. They will not levy any kind of angel tax in case of category 2 AIF also.